My dear friends, how many of you would like to feel high energy throughout your living hours? Please raise your hands.
Everybody.
Please raise your hands. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. And from the friends, how many of you would like to attract abundance, joyfulness and happiness in your life? Please raise your hands.
That is our inbuilt system, sir.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. But I really welcome each one of you for this favorite topic of mine called as healthy living through the practice of gratitude. First and foremost, I want to acknowledge each one of you sitting in this particular room and plus the people who are viewing this particular video. I can tell you one thing, that all you people, dynamic people, both in this room as well as those who are viewing, you are among the top 10% of the world's population who really invest on the most important asset that we human beings have, that is our own self. Yeah, because we are the biggest asset. Whatever you are going to manifest in your life, whatever you are going to experience in your life, whatever you are going to achieve in your life, kon lane wala hai wo? I am going to be the architect of it, yes or no? And when I keep on improving myself, I keep on sharpening myself, okay, I am making it more easier for me to actualize it, yes or no? How many of you agree with me? If you agree with me, please raise your hands. Thank you very much. Thank you. Okay. So I really want to acknowledge each one of you for being here and for participating here, and even those people who are observing and viewing this video. It also shows that you are the people who are on the lookout for good thoughts, good learnings and good teachings from whatever sources available, and thereby to empower yourself, enable yourself and educate yourself. So can we give a brilliant applause to everybody? Yeah, awesome. So I want to ask you for two favors, can I?
Yes.
I want you to raise your hands up, even the people who are there, and turn it around and acknowledge yourself and say, I am proud of myself.
I am proud of myself.
Yeah, I am proud of myself for who I am. Okay. And second one is, you know, can I ask you for one more favor? Can you please raise your hand like this? As I cannot reach out to all you people, can you on my behalf acknowledge your partner? Say, I am proud of you. I am really proud of you. I am really proud of you. Yes. Thank you. Thank you very much. Because what we just did just now is another two important practices which we need to do as human beings. Okay, it also flows from this particular concept of gratitude, or, you know, gratitude towards our own self. Yes or no? We need to be gratitude towards our body, towards our mind, towards our thoughts, and thereby, you know, remember, wherever your attention goes, wherever your focus goes, it expands, because energy goes there and you feel the manifestation of it. Okay. So I really want to acknowledge each one of you, and I want you to do this practice as well. Every time you do something good, acknowledge yourself. See, thankful to yourself. And wherever possible, as Vadesa rightly said, as you rightly observed, be grateful to others. Say the word thank you. It's a very, very powerful word. Yes or no?
Yes.
Yeah, absolutely. So friends, in this 1 hour which we are going to spend, can I share with you what we are going to cover? Can I?
Yeah, yes.
So first and foremost thing, I am going to share with you the genesis of gratitude. How does gratitude come about? Okay. How is it that this has got so much of prominence today in the world over, and everybody is talking about gratitude? So I wanted to give you a little bit of a background of it, the genesis of it. So once if you understand it, then you will be able to appreciate and thereby practice this process of gratitude. How many of you would like that?
Yes.
There. Thank you. Second one is, I want to also give you some of the highlights and the benefits in all, in a holistic aspect, in your health, wealth, happiness, joy in your existence as human being. Okay. So that it will motivate you. What's the word?
Motivate.
To practice this on an ongoing basis right from today. Right from today. Okay. So how many of you would like that? Thank you. Thank you. And last but not the least, as your coach, I'm going to give you one of the most powerful gratitude process template, which I learned from my teacher Alan Jones from USA, okay, which I've been doing for the last so many years, and I want to share it with each of you so that you can start practicing and get the benefits. How many of you would like that?
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. So that's what I intend to cover in the coming 60 minutes. Are you excited?
Yes.
If you're excited, say, I'm excited.
Yes.
Thank you. Can you just turn to your partner, give him a high five, say, boss, I'm excited. Good, good. So I'll do it for you. Yes. Awesome. Yeah, good. I tell you why. One of the benefits of gratitude is you feel high energy. And we are all here, you know, spending this 1 hour on that too on a Friday afternoon. That means you have come here to really learn and educate. Yes or no? So let's keep, can I request all of you to keep a high energy? Can I? So that we, my only intent is we really take back something of value. And each of you in this room, plus the people who are watching on the video, before this 1 hour gets over, the person who walked in into this particular room or for this program should not be the same person who walks out. That's what is my intention. You go back in with a more actualized person. Okay, are you game for that?
Yes.
If you are game for that, say yes.
Yes.
Awesome, awesome. So let me jump into the particular topic which we talked about gratitude. So gratitude is nothing but it's a most positive human emotion. What's the word? It's a most positive human emotion. And this human emotion is something which each and every human being can generate it on in his own violation, his own choice. Okay. But remember, gratitude is nothing but an emotion, is energy in motion. And energy comes from your thoughts. Right? And I wanted to give you a genesis of this particular process. Remember, we as human beings have got, you know how many thoughts per day? 60 to 70,000 thoughts, right? We shared last time as well. And out, absolutely, it's a research, yeah. And out of that 60 to 70,000 thoughts, do you know how many of them are positive?
Mostly negative.
How many are they positive? Approximately. Yeah, you're right, absolutely right. Around 10%. That means the rest of the 90% are negative and repetitive. Okay, so because of this particular percentage, you know, and this again, who has caused this? It's because it's been caused by us. Okay, nobody else is responsible. Remember, everything in your life, whatever happens, is who's responsible? I am responsible. Okay, this is because of the conditioning, the way, you know, we have been programmed, the way we have been, you know, surrounded, the environment. Everything has caused this particular thing, right? So, but at the same time, let me tell you one more thing. The God Almighty, okay, when He designed this beautiful, miraculous machine, okay, He did one more brilliant thing. Okay, even though you got 60-70,000 thoughts, at any given instant, how many thoughts do you have?
One.
Yeah, you can have only one thought in an instant. Okay, you can't have more than one. If you want to change it, you have an opportunity. You can substitute it. You can change it. But in an instant, you have only one thought. And normally, who chooses it?
We all.
Yeah. Unfortunately, I'll tell you one thing. In today's world, because we have not really been educated, we really have not been properly programmed, or we have not been conditioned, or we have not been nurtured well. Okay, even though many of us are highly educated, I totally agree with you. But in my opinion, I want to make this statement, you know, today's education is not very, very effective because of what? Because today's education is full of what?
Theory,
absolutely. Means what? It's full of, am I right? So this is not true education. True education is what? True education is, I'll come down to that. True education is this. That's what I promised you all today. You know, that true education is, a person walks into a true education, he gets a true education, and he goes back this. Okay? This is what is an impact of a true education. So what is this process called as?
Growing.
Growing, very good.
Transforming.
Yeah, it's called transformation, absolutely right. So true education is actually transformation.
And you're never too old for it.
Absolutely right. That's why I appreciate all of you being here, and the people who are there on the video also. You are people who are continuously on the journey of true education, that is transformation. So now let me just, because this has got a relevance to the gratitude process which we are going to learn. Because transformation is what? Is it that, you know, we all walked into this room at 5 feet 5 inches, we'll go back at 7 feet?
No.
Is it so? No. What will change?
Our internal.
Yes. Internal means?
Attitude.
Mindset. Brilliant. Absolutely. So, I really wanted to get present to this. True education is nothing but, you know, converting your limiting beliefs into liberating beliefs. What's the word?
Liberating.
Because ultimately all of us, you know, whatever actions you take, consciously or unconsciously, is all determined by this one factor. What is it? Hello, can you all read it?
Beliefs.
Okay. So, if you are doing very well in life, because I can promise you, all those people in this room, plus the people who are watching, you have a learning belief, yes or no? That's why you are here, otherwise you wouldn't be here. But these are good beliefs, these are liberating beliefs, which you have cultivated over a period of time, you have experienced it. But you may also have, let's see, all of us have got, we also have got limiting beliefs, the areas of life where you have not been really successful, nothing wrong. It may be because of some limiting beliefs. Okay. So, true education is breaking that barrier of converting those limiting beliefs into liberating beliefs. That's what we are here for. Hello. So, even on the aspect of gratitude, let me tell you, there are a lot of people who may have limiting beliefs about gratitude. It doesn't work here. If you say too many thank you, thank you, thank you, people will take you for granted. Yes or no? There are people who say that. Bosses say, now if I appreciate my subordinates more, they will become complacent. Hello, how many of you have heard this?
Yes.
Read this? Raise your hands if you agree with me. Thank you very much. Absolutely. So that's about limiting beliefs. Okay. So, I really want you to acknowledge you all, and I want you to get present to this, because transformation can happen only when you are with an intensity between the source and the receiver, and when you have got an open mind. Yes or no? You need to be open, observant and objective for you to really open an empty mind. Yeah. Open, and I would say that, you know, these three O's are very important for you to achieve things. You need to be open, observant and also objective. That's where it comes down to this. These three O's I wanted to get present to. Okay. Because when you adopt these three attitudes in your life, suddenly a lot of new things can open up. Yes or no? Yeah, many people don't see a lot of opportunities in their life, mainly because they got this, you know, what do you put for horses?
Close line.
Like that, close line. You know? So, but if you practice this, I promise you, you would be able to work it up. So, coming down to our genesis of gratitude, as I said, 60 to 70,000 thoughts, only 10% positive, and you have a choice of choosing one. Because my experience as a yoga teacher, as a corporate trainer, as a sportsman, is this, that most of the human beings have an experience that they don't have thoughts. Thoughts have them. Hello?
Yes.
Isn't it true? Thoughts have them. They don't have thoughts. Okay. That means you are actually carried away by the moods, feelings and emotions. Yes or no? Hello? Aaj subah jaldi kyun nahi utha? And why didn't we go for exercise? Kya bolenge hum log? Yaar, aaj time nahi mila. Aaj mood nahi hai. So, in this case, are you controlling your thoughts or thoughts controlling you? Thoughts control you. Absolutely. Many of the people who feel de-energized, who are low in energy, who are depressed, who are in inaction, is because of what? Is it because they are able to focus on the right thoughts, or is it they are allowing the negative thoughts to overcome them?
They open their door.
Yeah, they are allowing the negative thoughts to overcome them. So friends, this is very, very important. That's why this gratitude process is very, very critical, because gratitude process is nothing but focusing your thoughts or focusing your mind on positives of your life. And when you focus on the positive thoughts or positive areas of your life, automatically that leads to the manifestation of positivity in your life. Yes or no?
Yes.
Hello?
Yes.
Yeah. Let me give you the manifestation cycle. The manifestation cycle which we need to understand. Manifestation cycle. Okay. it starts with this, my friends. Okay, it starts with your thoughts. Your thoughts become your words. Words
become your action.
Become your action. Action repeated becomes your
habit.
Brilliant, sir. Habit becomes your character. Character becomes your destiny. I'll again repeat it, just for the understanding. This is what is called as manifestation cycle. Okay, it starts with thoughts. Thoughts becomes your words. Words becomes your action. Action becomes your habit. Habit becomes your character. Character determines your destiny. So friends, this is how is the genesis of a gratitude process. So in a gratitude process, what you do? You are focusing on what is good in your life. What is positive in your life. You see, in your life, out of the 10 things, 6 things may be going well. 4 things may not be going well. 4 means, I'm just taking an arbitrary number. Okay. Normally, what does our human mind do?
Think of negative only.
Yeah, they think about only the those things which is not working, right? And when you focus on, remember, where the focus goes, energy flows and results manifest. Okay, let me give you a small experiential learning here. Can I? Even the people who are watching the thing, I want you to give a comment to yourself. Okay, so I'm going to make some statement on the board. I want you to react immediately. Okay, give me a response. Okay, anybody? Start. Yes. I want response.
Exponential. Only like 4 are right, 1 is wrong.
Yeah, right. Good. Right. So, I could see your smile. So, you are about to say, yeah, Aruna, Mr. Dr. Arunaagiri, how can you make that silly mistake? Right. So we are automatically, as human beings, we are all programmed to do what? Observe what? Observe the wrong things. Error the thing, right? See, out of the 5, 4 are right, 1 is wrong. But our mind immediately went where? Hello?
I haven't noticed at all.
So I wanted to get present to this. Yeah. So I wanted to get present to this is what is again the genesis of a gratitude process. Okay. In all our lives, there are things which are going well, they are not going well. There may be something like this, even 50-50%. But still, it is your choice whether to focus on the positives or the negatives. Not that I would say that ignore those negatives. Learn from it and move forward. But spend your time appreciating, admiring, accepting, approving those positive things, because when you focus that energy on those positive things, what happens is they expand. Let me tell you one more thing, my friends. Universe loves approval and appreciation. Hello? Because when you approve, appreciate what is there in your life, what happens?
It expands.
More opportunities come. How many of you agree with me? Yeah, more opportunities come to you. That's what is the actual way this universe has been programmed. Yes.
You told the cycle, the character becomes destiny.
Right.
But destiny, everything is predetermined.
No, yeah, we'll come down to this afterwards. But I for one believe that your destiny is in
your hand.
And I can absolutely challenge, I mean, I would really urge you to always come from this paradigm, because this thought that destiny is predetermined is what? Is basically a what? It's a belief. Is it a liberating belief or a limiting belief?
Of course, limiting.
Yeah, because the moment you say, "Arey yaar, mera the destiny is not in my hand."
I'm not talking about the entire destiny, but part of destiny is predetermined. The remaining, you can change it.
Yeah, absolutely. But which will make you more powerful, or which will make you more active, which will make you more purushartha? Which will? What thought process or what belief? That ultimately everything is in my hand. You're right. Basically, you know, here I wanted to get present to that, you know, sometimes we always relate to the output. Yeah, here I would like to give you a small equation. The equation is this, you know. Just to answer your question, you know, what's the equation? E plus R is equal to O. E stands here for environment. Is the environment in your hand? No. Okay. Coming down to output. Is the output in your hand?
Yes.
Fully?
No.
Totally?
Partly.
Yeah, partly. Okay. So you don't have a control. R is response. Is your response, the way you respond, is in your hand? It is in your hand. So from that perspective, I want you to get present to that response is always in your hand. And you know, at any given point of time, you can determine that. Whereas environment and output is not in your hand. So I want you to just you to relook at your own self and come back from this putting. Yeah. Response, yeah. Response is when you think and act, not animalistic. But I wanted to get present to that. Come from this belief that ultimately everything is in my hand, and if I want it, I can always do my very best in whatever thing. You're right. Sometimes you may put the best effort, still the results doesn't come. But there you don't blame anybody else. You see, okay, I will relook at it, check out where I've gone right, wrong, and then reposition myself. But never feel handicapped, helpless, like a victim, because you for you to be able to actualize the full potential of human being, you need to always come from this factor: I will do my very best, I will give my 100% to whatever I do, and then I will take it forward. Okay, I will take a question answer at the end of the session also. Okay, good. Now coming down to this gratitude process, as I said, the genesis is you have a choice as to which portion of your life you have to focus on. So if you focus on what is positive in your life, that will automatically expand, and that will automatically give you more of that. Okay, because whatever, wherever your attention goes, focus goes, energy flows, and when the energy flows there, automatically the results manifest. So that is the ultimately crux of gratitude. And especially in the morning, if you can do the gratitude process, what will happen? When you do a gratitude process, do you feel high energy or low energy?
Very high.
Absolutely. And how many of you agree with me that energy, higher energy, gives you higher
results?
Yeah, because when your energy is high, what will happen to your results?
Very high.
Results also is high. All areas of life, be it money, be it your career, be it your relationship. Okay. Ultimately, higher energy. And one of the crux of having high energy is to follow the gratitude process. It has been now documented and proven that when you exercise gratitude on a continuous, consistent basis, it has a humongous benefit on your health. Hello? It has been scientifically proven. You know, biologically, there are, you know, the neuroplasticity sets in. Neuroplasticity is the new science of how the brain gets restructured by your thought process. Plus, it has got a huge impact on your cellular biology. Even your cells get transformed when you have a transformational thought. Absolutely. They become vibrant. And they also, it has been proven that your immunity system also goes up. Your immunity becomes better. When you are naturally, when you practice gratitude, you are in a high energy, you are in a happier state, you are in a joyous state, and it has been proven that you suddenly start feeling more vibrant, more vitality, and then you see that your ability to face any external invasion of any organisms also is taken care of. Your immunity goes up many folds. In fact, there are cases where it has been proven that when a person has been happy, he has been able to even cause cure of cancer. How many of you have seen Secret? Have you seen a cigarette? Yeah. There is, if you see the full thing, there is a cassette about a lady in America where when she was diagnosed with cancer, she just went about just being happy by observing, by seeing all the comedy films and being thankful, being grateful. Suddenly her energy went up, and within a matter of a few weeks or months, her cancer got cured. Similarly about wealth. Okay, just imagine if you are grateful and if you say thank you to people for the order that they give you. If you are thankful towards your customers, what will happen to the customer?
They will be happy.
And because of that?
You will be happy. Happiness in your
Right, right. And then what will happen? I'm talking about absolute metrics of business.
Business.
Huh?
Why?
You'll go and tell 10 people.
Correct, very good. Yeah,
no,
see.
No need to advertise.
Absolutely. I wanted to get present to that, you know, in business, because I do coach big corporates both in India and abroad on how to build profitable customers for life. And how to scale up your business 10x. One of our signature program is 10x business booster or 10x sales booster, okay, where we, you know, over a period of two days, we are able to generate for corporates 1/4 worth of inquiries or sale, okay. And in that I touch upon this point. See, when you keep your customer happy, or when you give a customer an amazing experience, he will give you repeat orders. Yes or no?
Yes.
He may give you, as you at least said, referrals. Yes or no?
Yes.
He may give you testimonials. Yes or no?
Yes.
Yeah, because one referral is equal to 15 cold calls.
Yeah.
Hello? Yeah. And repeat sale is where the real profit kicks in. Yeah, first sale may not give you much profits, because first sale will be automatically a smaller sale because the trust is still not set in. But once if you are able to win the trust of your customer gives you bigger order. Yes or no?
Yes.
That's where you'll make more profits. And as the cycle keeps on moving up, you get a higher and higher sale with a higher and higher profitability. That becomes a branding. That's what is trust cycle, right? So even gratitude, when you express gratitude towards a customer for giving you a business and giving you an opportunity to serve him, he automatically gives you this. So your health, wealth, happiness. Happiness again is internal, it's not external. Yes or no?
Yes.
Yeah. Can happiness be bought from outside? That's what.
Everybody will be happy.
Absolutely right. Money does not give you, it's not an access to happiness. Money can buy pleasures, but it does not give you happiness. But happiness comes when? Within. It's an inside out, not outside in. Yes or no?
Absolutely.
And inside out means what? When do I really feel happy is when I'm able to make a contribution to others. Yes or no?
Yes.
Yeah.
If you are satisfied, you become
happy. Yeah, effort. Now, whenever any human being can make a contribution to others, especially when you help another human being without expecting anything back, unconditional, that is the time when you really, the happiness kicks in, right? And human beings have been programmed. You know, you have got something called as a dose. Dopamine, oxytocin, serotonin, and endomorphins. These are all
happy
internal hormones. They are all happy hormones. These all are set in by what? They are set in by the
thoughts.
By your thoughts and experiences and feelings and emotions. Yes or no?
Yes.
And that you can do it by this process. And that's where this particular process of gratitude and the health, not only financial, even your physical health and your relationship health, all of them depend upon this particular aspect of gratitude, which we can all practice. Okay, was it useful? Now I'm going to teach you the thing about how exactly we can work it up. And I request all of you to put off your mobile phones, please, take it forward. Now, do you all have a piece of paper and a pen? If it is there, it would be very ideal. If not, you know, I want you to remove some paper which is there, because I wanted to do this exercise, which actually I have been able to. It's come from Alan Jones, one of the biggest human behavioral scientists in this particular aspect, who has studied this particular gratitude process in its depth. And if you can just follow this process every day morning, and it doesn't take more than about 10 to 15 minutes for you to do this, but if you do this on a consistent basis, you will suddenly see that you suddenly start in a different energy level, in a different mindset, and with a different amount of power which is there within you. This is a way of triggering your power within. It also gives you the power to be primed up. The primed up thing comes from the concept of pumps. Okay, without priming some of the...
For
the whole day? Yes, absolutely. And if you keep on doing this process continuously, you'll work it up. Okay, good. Thank you very much. I appreciate. Yeah. Sir, can you just take a seat? And can you please put off your mobile phones, please? Because mobile is one of the biggest hurdles for learning. Okay, and this needs to be always kept in silence, especially when you are coming for a learning session. Okay. Now this is a gratitude process which I am going to share with you all, and I would request all of you to actually do it with me so that it becomes experiential learning, and which is what gives you a good start off to this process. Okay. The first question I want all of you to answer is, make a daily goal. Please write it down. Make a daily goal. Okay. That means, and after that, after writing that question, make a daily goal. Okay. And this is what, you know, the entire process starts with these 5 questions in the morning and 3 questions in the evening. Okay. So I'm going to make you go through this process so that I want you to actually experience it, because experience is what gives you, you know, a little bit more conviction in what we are talking about, and that will what will make you do it. Okay. Make a daily goal. Make a daily goal means the morning, get up in the morning and say, okay, today I have got a goal. Goal doesn't mean that, you know, something which is transactional. I want you to think in terms of a bigger goal as a human being. Okay. Like I would say that today I am going to live in a consciousness that everything is okay. Is my daily goal. Okay. Tomorrow I am going to live with the thing, I am not going to criticize, condemn, complain the whole day. Okay. Third day can be, I am going to give a genuine appreciation to as many people as possible. Okay. So these can be the different types of goals that you can have. Okay. There are so many different types. Okay, today I am going to be helpful to as many people as possible in whatever way. Every opportunity to make a contribution, to help somebody, I'll do it. This is my goal. And I'm going to be conscious about it. Okay. So I want you to write an answer for this.
Today I will not be judgmental.
Very good. Awesome. Brilliant. Today I'm not going to be judgmental. Today I'm not going to be righteous. Righteous means kya? Mera hi soch right hai. Bas aisa nahi hai. I'm going to be open-minded. Or I'm going to be 3 O's. I'm going to be observant, objective, or open-minded. So these can be the different goals. Take one goal so that on that one goal you can focus and practice it the whole day. Okay. So I'll give you about 20 seconds to answer this. Make a daily goal. Second. Okay, are you ready? Can I move forward? The next question you're going to answer is, how am I going to contribute to others? Okay. The second question you answer is, आज के दिन में मैं दूसरों के लिए क्या करूंगा? How am I going to help others, contribute others, serve others? Okay, you have to give an answer. See, let me give you a small background. Why is this question asked? हमारे सबसे बड़ा दुविधा क्या है? सबसे बड़ा चैलेंज क्या है? हम क्यों दुखी रहते हैं?
मेरा
good. मेरा
Craving,
very good. Good answers.
Expectation.
हमारा focus कहाँ पर है?
Others.
मेरा.
यहाँ पर है. मेरा. I, me, myself. Because of that, because of so much of over focus on myself, I get upset because my expectation is not fulfilled. Or मुझे जो चाहिए. I am not bothered about what others are doing. I am only bothered about me. And that's the reason why we are all suffering and upset. How many of you agree with me?
Yes.
Yeah. So this question is purposely put here. Let me tell you, this is one of the best format anywhere in the world. We are all lucky to have this. And I really want you to appreciate this. Both the people in this room as well as people who are watching. Do this. Okay, write down what are you going to contribute to others, what are you going to give to others. Okay, write down. Kya de sakte? See, you can give in terms of, you know, 40, you can give by touch, you can give by talent, you can give by your treasure, or you can give by your time. ऐसा नहीं कि देना में सिर्फ पैसा देना, लोगों को भी एक डर है, मेरा पैसा है, अरे बॉस पैसा भी एक सिर्फ चीज है. You can just spend some time with somebody, old people, just spend some time with them, they would be happy, happy, right? Yes or no?
Yes.
You can just give your talent, something. So write down. I'll give you about 30 seconds. Even the people who are watching this video, please write down. Think in terms of the 4 T's: time, talent, touch, treasure. And as I told you, universe loves givers. Yes or no? And what you give
comes back
to you. Yeah.
Live with kindness. Live with caring.
Absolutely.
Live with faith and generous sharing.
Absolutely. Sir, this
faith
can be
truth, for when you do, all good things return to you.
Absolutely. Brilliant, sir. Very good. Awesome. Brilliant. That's what it is. Okay, everybody? Lika? Okay, good. Now let me go to the next question. The next question is, you know, make a list of 10 things which you value, for which you are grateful to God. Okay? आपके जिंदगी में ऐसे 10 चीज क्या है? Okay, both tangible and intangible, which is there in your life, for which you are grateful to God. Okay, make a list of it. No? Both tangible, right? Start from your own self. My own self, health, education, blah blah blah, all those things.
They say when you get them in the morning, you have to be thankful.
Ah?
Yes, open your
mouth. You are alive. Yeah, absolutely. Start with that, sir. I'm alive. That you can be grateful for that. But think about more and more things. Okay. Can you shout out? What are things which comes to your mind? Why are you grateful? 10 things. Shout out one of the things.
I have a place to live and stay.
Brilliant. I have a place in Bombay to have a house here. Brilliant. Sir, what's your...
What Gita says, the fact that you are born a human being itself is a gift.
Brilliant. Absolutely. You are born a human. I am born a human being. There are 85 lakh different species. Machar se leke. There are so many things, animals. Yeah, but we have been given a human body, human life. Brilliant. So what are you grateful for, sir? Kya cheez aap yaad kar sakte ho ya focus kar sakte ho jiske liye aap shukr guzar ho?
Suraj,
very good. Yeah, sun comes every day morning and every day evening it sets, and every day, remember, just one day sun doesn't come, the entire ecosystem would go for a toss. So write down those 10 things. I'll give you about 20 seconds. Think of 10 things that you are grateful to God for. Okay. Write it down. Don't assume. Yaad rahega. Likho. Jab likhoge na aap, aapko yaad rahega, mehsoos hoga, uska ek power aapko jaan mein aayega. Okay. Awesome. I really appreciate all of you for being so very coachable, and I really appreciate all of you for taking action. Because learning, let me tell you friends, is an active process, not a passive process. Why I make you, you know, raise your hands, you know, do a high five is all because we need to create energy. And energy is what ultimately leads to results. Good, awesome. Now coming down to the fourth thing. Okay, I want you to answer this fourth question. Fourth question is, what is it that others do for you? Okay, what is it that others do for you of value which you are grateful for? Means aapke zindagi mein itne log aapko contribute karte hain, right? To unke bare mein sochiye. Okay, there are so many people, right? From the time you are awake till the time you go to sleep, there are hundreds of people who are contributing to your life. Yes or no, man? हम कभी इसके बारे में सोचते नहीं, वी टेक इट फॉर ग्रांटेड. कैन यू जस्ट राइट इट डाउन, व्हाट इज इट दैट? या
my sweeper woman who takes my garbage.
Absolutely right, sir. You point blank. Just imagine, subah uthte pani aa jata hai. Raat ko koi 4 baje jaake wo nal khula hua hai. Hello. और हमारे हमारे जो वॉचमैन है वो ऊपर जाके आपके नल खुले करके आप व्हेन यू गो टू द वॉशरूम योर वाटर देयर यस और नो यस इमेजिन इफ इट वाज नॉट देयर और सर व्हाट इज रेडी सेड द गार्बेज वाज नॉट पिक्ड अप व्हाट वुड हैपन वुड यू बी लीवेबल
नो या फर्स्ट थिंग इन द मॉर्निंग थैंकफुल
राइट
गिव हर अ स्माइल
गिव हर अ स्माइल दे आर डूइंग दैट फॉर यू डोंट से मैं उसको पैसा दे रहा हूं बॉस पैसा दे रहा ठीक है बट समबडी इज डूइंग दैट जॉब इन ऑर्डर फॉर यू टू बी ग्रेटफुल फॉर यस और नो आई कांट हियर यू
Yes.
Absolutely. Okay, good. So, just write down, I'll give you about 20 seconds for you to write down whatever comes to your mind and go microscopic. And you will see that there are hundreds and thousands of people who take care of. In this, when I came, I really want to thank Madam here. She was prompt. She had kept everything ready. So, we could deliver so many short talks and the long talks as well. Which my basic intention is, it may impact some human being's life anywhere in this world. That's what God has given me, this knowledge and this passion of teaching. Yes or no? So can we give Madam a big round of applause? Can we give her a round of applause? Yeah. Thank you, Madam. Absolutely. Good. Are you through with this? So can we just take a revision of what we wrote? First one was what? Making a
daily
goal. Second one was? How am I going to contribute or give to others? Third one is? Making a
list of
10 things for which I am grateful to God. Fourth one is? What are the others doing for you? Okay, for which you are grateful to God. Okay. Now the fifth question which you need to answer every day, my friends, is this. Okay. Why am I happy? Why am I happy right now?
Seeing you.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Yeah, right. Roj, aap jab subah uthenge, to just yaad kariye. Why am I happy right now? Okay. Har shan mein, agar aap focus karoge, kisi na kisi cheez ke liye aap khush ho sakte ho. Right? Hello? Yeah, so please write down. I'll give you 20 seconds. Varun sir was very kind to say, compliment me. I thank you, sir, for that. But write something here, something which is there, which you really mehsoos karte ho.
Okay. Singing of the
birds. Brilliant, sir. Absolutely.
So thankful.
Chirping of the birds. Yeah, why not? In the morning you get sun is rising. Okay.
Yeah,
beautiful
happy.
Breeze.
So why should I be unhappy? See how happy they are.
Right. Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. So what are you happy about right now? Think about that. Think about that and write it down. Okay. Verbalize it. Articulate it and write it down. And this you need to do. I promise you, if you start doing it every day, it doesn't take more than about 10 minutes for you to complete the entire process. Okay. So this is what you do in the morning. All the five questions. Okay. How are you all feeling right now? Aapne abhi ye process kiya.
I always feel better.
Good experience kiya. The moment you wrote down all these answers for each of these questions. Remember, these questions hook the mind. Questions make you think. That's why in the form of a question I am giving. I am not giving a statement. These are all questions. Okay. Now, this is the morning thing. Morning gratitude process. Evening again, as soon as you come back, you are supposed to do three questions. Hello? Three questions. The first question which you will answer in the night, evening, which I want you to do today evening again. Okay. The question before sleeping. Before sleeping, you will answer this question. So, well, the answer is, okay, how well did I accomplish my goal? Aapne subah ek goal likha tha, yaad hai? You made a goal. Ki today, I will live in the consciousness that everything is okay. Okay, today I will appreciate. Or today, whatever you wrote. Okay, how well did you accomplish your daily goal? Okay, so this you'll answer. You'll do a introspection, reflection, and you'll answer this question. So this will enable you to do what? Why is this important?
Sleep better.
You sleep better. There's a completion. Good, good point.
It's a sleep therapy.
It's a sleep therapy. Good point, sir. Absolutely. And second is, you know, you will be able to measure your progress. Yeah, maybe not that. Nobody is perfect in this world. You say, okay, two instances maine kiya. My genuine appreciation, ek jagah pe maine nahi kiya. Doesn't matter. So what? That's a reflection. Don't blame. Don't become guilty. But just acknowledge that and move forward. Okay? Okay, everybody clear?
Yeah.
Any question? And iske baad. Second one is, now, during the entire day, when you do the introspection, what attitude, skill, knowledge improved? So, attitude, skill, knowledge, my friends, in all is called as capability. Improved. For me, today. Means, आपके पूरे दिन में जो आपने introspection किया, मेरे ऐसी कौन सी चीज है जिसमें मैंने विकसित देखा, मैं विकास देखा, growth देखा. Okay? और today ना, when I spoke to somebody, I could do a lot of nice listening. मैंने उसको अच्छा सुना, listening. अब तक कभी मैं जो मैं किसी से बात करता तो मैं सिर्फ this time I was listening better. Okay, today I got a chance to share and I shared more powerfully. Okay, today I was more caring and empathetic towards my patient, towards my students, towards my participants, towards my colleagues. Okay, today na, when I was doing that Excel programming on the computer, I did without any mistake. So you just, what are you doing? You're absolutely. You are acknowledging yourself for doing something good or where you have grown. My friends, every human being wants to grow. It's an internal urge. Yes or no? How many of you agree with me? Raise your hands if you agree with me. Yeah. So when you acknowledge that, what it leads to, what for you as a human being?
Prosperity.
Yeah, it makes you feel
prosperous.
Happy, good, well-being, joyous. Yes or no? Yes. So that's what it is. Okay. And the last one, my friends, is this. Okay. Why am I happier? Now, or the question is, for what can I be, what and why, what can I be happier right now? Means, kis cheez ke liye main abhi is waqt mein, is shan mein, raat ko, main aur kushi ka ehsaas kar saku. Okay, so the night before you go into sleep, what are you doing? You are again focusing your thought on something which you can be happier about. Okay. Raat ko sote waqt kis cheez ka happier ho sakte ho aap?
I have a bed to sleep.
Brilliant. Awesome.
Most people say, and they are right, even as you agree, that the most horrible thoughts come only in the night. Because during the day you are busy.
Right.
So how to eliminate those?
So what do you feel? You give me the answer.
By your lecture.
Absolutely, sir. Abhi horrible thoughts kyun aa rahe unko? Because reason is, you have been right now programmed. Aapka programming itna negative ho chuka hai. Because let me tell you very factly. Ye jo 90% thoughts negative kyun ho rahe? Agar aap dekhiye, hum log kya karte hai? Raat ko sone ke pehle hum news on karte hai, right? News kya hai?
Absolute negative.
They say CNN is, you know, CNN sunde na, constant negative news. Hello? Yeah, news is what? North, east, west, south se sab negative bejo. Agar aap paper padhte ho, kya hai? Aajkal subah se raat tak koi Shiv Sena ka ye kiya, isne waisa kiya, wo mere ko CH chief minister chahiye, mere ko wo chahiye, mere ko balatkari wo problem hai, ye aisa hai, waisa hai, blah blah blah.
The best time to read papers is afternoon.
Avoid. And if I would say, totally avoid, because whatever news has to come will come to you. Avoid newspapers as much as possible. Instead of that, do reading. You know, these books, are the frozen thoughts of great people. You can get in touch with them. For reading is one. Night also, if you can read some lovely books before going to sleep, you are putting what in your mind? Or you are putting what? You are reading. You are seeding. Yeah, you are seeding your mind with thoughts. Just read two papers, pages on that, and see what happens. You put what thought? You put positive thoughts, because these are all frozen thoughts of experiences, right? Now, for example, if I always say this book is worth 1 crore because that much of money I have spent in training myself and going through the experiences, you get, yeah. This is also available. If somebody is interested, you can pick it up from Nair, sir. For people who are on the video, if you want to buy this Unleash Your Potential or Jogging for Life Success, this is on the basis of my 18 years of coaching children on basketball. I have come out with 7 distilled principles of life. And this, I promise you, if anybody adopts these 7 principles, he automatically can take his life to the next level. Okay? It's my 18 years of experience and study. And last one, now this is called being customer centric. These are signature corporate program which you do across India and abroad. Okay, all these are available on Amazon, on Flipkart as well. And for participants who are here, if you are interested, you can meet my colleague Mr. Nair. He will be able to help you out with this these books as well. Okay, but these are, remember, invest in books. Every month, I would say, each of you should invest at least in one book every month, minimum. Of course, you all are coming here and help, library has got books. But apart from that, also invest. Because in your house, I would say your gold ornaments or your cash or FD receipt is not the real asset. If I want to really judge a person, how good he is, how wealthy he is, you know what I'll do? I will go and check in his house. Is
library.
Library. Yeah. Soft copy is one. But do you want your children to learn, to have the good habit of reading? Hello? Do you want them? Invest on that and keep it there. When you are not there, maybe they'll pick it up and read it. Yes or no?
Yes.
When they see their parents reading it, they automatically get energized to it. Nazar ke samne hona bahut zaruri hai, boss. Bahut zaruri hai. Hum log ke bolte hai digital milta na, hum log kyun invest karega? That's a way of rationalizing for not. Yeah. It's good. See, wherever it's possible, you can use it. But use it as a complementary along with the physical book. But the physical book should not be substituted. You ask any great person to. Narayana Murthy, Azim Premji, Warren Buffet, Bill Gates, they have got only one habit which is common to all of them. One good habit, reading. All of them are voracious readers. And they are smart because they are able to get the thoughts from so many great people, and which becomes easier for them. Okay, good. So, last question you answer before you go to sleep is, why am I happy right now? What can I be happy about right now? Okay, what I may be happy about right now. Okay, so bring in that thought, delve on that, and let it seep into your subconscious mind. That again gives you a high level of energy and happiness. So friends, these are 3 questions in the evening, 5 questions in the morning. Okay, if you can do this gratitude process on a continuous basis, okay, you suddenly see that your health, wealth, happiness, relationship, all of them go to the next level, and you become truly a powerful human being who can make a difference in this world.
You can change your destiny.
Absolutely, you can change your destiny just by this one simple process. Because gratitude process is today considered to be the most powerful human emotion. It is, but this process is considered to be one of the most transformational process that anybody can adopt in their life and see the results immediately. You don't have to wait for 1 month or 1 year for the benefit to happen. How many of you right now, after completing this particular small exercise, feel more energetic? Raise your hands. Okay. Are you feeling more joyous? Yeah. Are you feeling more fulfilled? Yeah. Even the people who are observing this, do this and see. Suddenly you will see that within a matter of just a few minutes, you can shift your energy and you can feel more alive, more vibrant, more enthusiastic in life. Okay, so friends, this is what I wanted to share with you. Now I also am open to taking up any questions you want to ask me. Okay, so this is what. Okay,
thank you,
thank you very much. Thank you.
Lovely.